So European World Cup qualifying from yesterday's games. I'm going to make a reaction to today's games tomorrow. So yesterday we had Group C with Germany against Norway, which was a 6-0 drubbing for a German team that is on the brink of qualification and can clinch qualification with, I believe, either a tie or a win on the road in Northern Ireland next month in October. This was the most emphatic German victory of the group, unless I think they beat San Marino by a larger margin. But still, even a team like Norway, you don't expect Germany to win by such by that much. Norway is very much a Scandinavian side that has declined in recent years. They are arguably the worst team in Scandinavia, behind the Faroe Islands. Germany is perfect with 24 points from 8 victories. They stand a good chance of being the only European side to have all 30 points from 10 games and 10 wins. So, for Germany, there's not much to talk about because you expect them to top this group. The other game in this group, Azerbaijan versus San Marino. Big victory for Azerbaijan, 5-1 over the San Marinese, but good for San Marino. They scored a goal. I think only their second goal of their World Cup qualifying campaign this cycle. Azerbaijan, 5 goals, comfortable victory, but they are still eliminated from the World Cup qualifying phase. And then the most important match was Northern Ireland playing at home against the Czech Republic. And honestly, Northern Ireland are guaranteed to finish top in the top two of this group now I believe 19 points. That's crazy. And Czech Republic are at 9 points, so Northern Ireland are full 10 points ahead of the Czech Republic. This was really unexpected because when the draw for these groups were made, I thought that the race for second in this group was going to be really, really close. But Northern Ireland, by far and away, the best team other than Germany. Comfortable victory over the Czech Republic. The Czech Republic looked toothless up front. They looked like they were not really much of a threat going forward whatsoever. I watched highlights of that match yesterday before I went out with my best friend. Northern Ireland are guaranteed to at least finish in the playoff spot, and if they can get a miracle victory at home in Windsor Park, that puts them in contention to potentially win the group, though I don't think they will because they are 5 points behind Germany with 2 games remaining, and just beating them at home will not be enough. But this Northern Irish side, I don't think anyone wants to draw them in the playoffs. When that takes place, I think next month, I really don't think anyone should want to play them across 2 legs. And they honestly deserve to be seeded, so I hope they avoid Portugal and Italy. Elsewhere, we had in Group E, Poland with a victory at home over Kazakhstan, pretty much the standard they needed to keep pace in this group to remain in first. They are still in first with 19 points. A big turnaround from their 4-0 loss to Denmark last week. Denmark coming from behind to win in Armenia, a team in the past that has caused them a lot of problems in World Cup and European Championship qualifying. So this was a big victory for Denmark. And Denmark seemed to be making a late surge. 2 wins, 6 points, 8 goals scored, and only 1 conceded across 2 games. Including that 4-0 victory over, in my opinion, a slightly overrated Polish side. So Montenegro is on 16 points, just 3 behind the Poles. They are in third place, though, due to the count of the head-to-head result against Montenegro. But otherwise, they are level on points, goal difference, number of goals scored, and number of goals conceded with the Montenegrins. Montenegro getting an important home victory over Romania, who is now eliminated after a very disappointing qualifying campaign in a really weird group. Montenegro is now second in the group with 16 points, but Poland is by no means safe. Both Montenegro and Denmark are breathing down their necks, only 3 points behind them. It looks like it's going to be a very interesting race to the finish. I do think Poland will ultimately finish in first and qualify directly. It's just going to come down between Denmark and Montenegro, who gets that playoff spot. But Denmark looking really, really good at the moment. Let's see if they can continue that until next October, a month from now. And then in Group F, we have, I believe it was Scotland getting a pretty straightforward victory at home over Malta. They really should have done their best to rack up the score here in case this group comes down to goal difference in determining second spot. But you expect Scotland to defeat Malta, you know. Elsewhere, we had Slovenia getting a convincing victory at home against Lithuania. I believe Slovenia is now on, 14 points or something. So they're still very much in contention for second, along with rivals Slovakia, who they lost to last week. So Scotland and Slovenia, you know, they're still in it. They can still make a push for second. But they would have to make sure they finish as one of the eight best runners-up so that they can make it to a playoff. And then we have the big match of the group, which was England versus Slovakia. Slovakia taking an early lead in the third minute through Nemec. And in the live standings while that match was going on, Slovakia was on top of the group with 18 points and England on 17. That would see them qualify directly, but they could not hold on to that lead as England came from behind to win the match 2-1. So Slovakia could not get any result from that game, which is unfortunate because the way they played against England, both at home and away in this qualifying campaign, I feel like they deserve to draw somewhere, at least, and not to lose both games. But England coming from behind, a great goal by Rashford to give them the victory. And England are on 20 points, a full five ahead of Slovakia, who are in second with 15. So pretty much one more win would secure England's passage directly to the World Cup, or even a draw would be enough if Slovakia drops points in their next game. So it looks like England is properly on the road to Russia. Slovakia, Slovenia, and Scotland will still be battling out for third, while Lithuania and Malta are pretty much done. So highlights from yesterday's games, Slovakia coming close to overtaking England in the group, close but no cigar. Going to be a very interesting race for second between the three S's, Scotland, Slovenia, Slovakia. Group E, also Poland not getting an easy ride. Close between the top three sides in that group as well. Denmark looking particularly dangerous. And in Group C, pretty much wrapped up sooner than expected with Northern Ireland just being on a completely different level from the Czechs and the Norwegians and the Azerbaijanis, very well coached under Michael O'Neill. These guys can get back to the World Cup for the first time since 1986. So those are my reactions. I will give my reactions to today's European games tomorrow, as well as my reaction Costa Rica-US game, as I promised. South American qualifying reaction, African qualifying reaction, and even Asian qualifying reactions. So expect anywhere between 4 to 5 videos tomorrow. So yeah, I'll see you guys in my next one. Thank you for watching. Have a good night. Much love and peace out.